15 nations are members of the Atlantic Alliance. What do we know of our allies? What do we know, for example, of the Germans? In one short film, we cannot meet them all, so let us take one town to represent the country and four people in it to represent the town. Let us meet, then, some people in Stuttgart.
I find it difficult to write letters. But my father, well, that's different. He's always writing to me. He wants me to leave Germany and go back to work for him at home in Sardinia. But I've so many brothers and sisters there. And besides, one of the reasons why I left was to find some sort of independent life for myself. There have been times, though, when I felt like going back. You see, for foreigners like myself, Germany can be difficult. I found it so, especially when I first arrived. It's all so different from home. The temperament, the language, the way of life. Everything is so formal and impersonal. Well, certainly to begin with. There's always a sort of cosmopolitan quarter around a railway station, and at first I used to end up there, standing about, talking to my own countrymen. We felt apart from the life of the city and tended only to mix with one another. You know, in the compounds where we live. But I've been in Germany now for 2 years. I've even got to know the language a little. And the more I learn, the more interesting life becomes, and the easier it is to get to know some of the people. The first real friend I made was Klaus. He was, in a way, a bit like me, a stranger to the town. You see, he'd come to the West from Eastern Germany, as he wanted a freer way of life. Soon after coming here, he married, and he now has a daughter. Klaus's wife had a boy, Martin, by a previous marriage. She's from East Germany, too. And when she came here, she left her son behind. Later, she felt that she had to have him with her, and so she took the risk and went back to East Germany to get him. When they came to the border, Martin fell asleep. That was lucky. You see, he was young, and if he'd told the East German border guards too much, they wouldn't have let them through. The menace of this border seems to affect everyone, and one is never far away from it. Makes a big difference to the people, and it takes time for the foreigner to understand what it means. Divided homes and families. You see, East Germany is cut off and isolated. While on this side of the border, the country is a free part of the Western world. I live away from home too, but there are no mines or guard towers or barbed wire to stop me from going back. All this is a relic of Germany's troubled past, but there's nothing negative about life today. In the West, you feel very much at the heart of things. You know, of European, of international affairs. One's always coming across people from other countries. Not just tourists, but businessmen and people who work here. And Germany is obviously a thriving country. I sometimes think their progress is due to a great capacity for work. The people here really work, and it can be difficult for someone easygoing like myself to fit in with this kind of dedication. I've had some awful jobs here, but I like my present one. It's well paid, and I've got a good foreman, and that helps when it comes to getting on with the other men at the factory. Of the friends I've made, I liked Servek very much. He's a bit like some of my uncles at home in my own country, and he's obviously very much part of the land. Generous and strong, and he's done a lot round here to modernize the wine business. He was a founder member of the local cooperative. I like him very much too. I don't really know him well. I just met him at a party. He's strong too, but very relaxed and a great talker. I never understand much of what he says, but it's fascinating to listen. You see, he's eccentric, different, and yet in a way very much like Servek and some of the other people from this part of the country. He was once a fairground boxer, a sort of tramp. He wasn't always rich and famous. There was a time when he wandered all over North Africa and places like that. He sometimes says that talking about modern art makes him feel depressed, and I must say I can understand him there. Like Servek, I like the older things, the farmhouses, and the way the vineyards come right down into the city. But I can see, as he does, that modernization is necessary and a good thing. Look at the houses and flats they built for ordinary people in areas that were completely devastated in the war. The one thing I find a bit difficult to take is the churches. The modern ones look too much like sheep pens, but I suppose it's what goes on inside that matters. Zervek's own church is an older one, and he took me there once to a service. He's a Protestant. I'm a Catholic, and I like best the old and ritual forms of my religion.
Oh.
It's strange to look back and think how dull and formal I used to find things here. Then I began to see in Vorn, and later in the others I got to know, a sense of fun and an ability to relax that I never noticed at first. I've always liked football, of course, and the Germans seem to get pretty worked up about it too. These championship matches are televised and broadcast all over the country. Mind you, life can be pretty intense all round, though in a disciplined way that seems to me to be characteristic. My father wouldn't like it much, but I've come to prefer it. Crowds, traffic, and all the rest. This is a prosperous place. Having money and owning things means a lot. It's a way of life, and I feel, in a way, that I've got to know the whole of Germany through the people I've met here, especially in the places I know best, like the factory and the older markets. And life has become much better than in those old railway station days. There's a lot of mineral water in these parts, and people come from all over to drink it. But it's not for me. I'd rather drink Zervex wine. But I suppose what did surprise me most is that in what is, after all, not a very big city, there's always so much to see and do. I don't know whether I'll stay in Germany or not. Maybe I'll go home one day. But anyway, not yet. Whatever happens, though, whenever I think of Germany, I'll think not of the past with prejudice, but of all my friends. Take Zervek, for example. He's a good man. He was a prisoner of war in Scotland, and he says he could have stayed. But he was born and bred in Stuttgart, so back he came. He's happy too, most of the time, the way things are.
Das können wir nachher schön spielen im Urlaub. Wenn wir im Urlaub sind, können wir das prima machen. Hast du Zeit genug?
Klaus, he's curious about things, like so many Germans of his age, and eager. He and his wife will spend hours discussing what goes on and the way the world outside Germany is going. As long as the kids will let them, of course. Servek, Klaus and his family, the foreman at the factory, and all the other people I've come to know. These to me mean Stuttgart. These to me mean Germany. Because these to me are friends.